In this video, we focus on a key reaction of amines. That is the reaction of amines with carboxylic acids. The product of this reaction is an amide functional group. This reaction is essential across biology because this is how we form the linkages between individual amino acids within proteins. And that's why I have an elaborate three-dimensional structure here of some proteins in the background of this slide. In upcoming videos, we'll look in more detail at proteins, but for now, we need to get comfortable and familiar with this key reaction of amines with carboxylic acids. In the reaction, what we will do is take a primary or secondary amine, react it with a carboxylic acid, and in a reversible reaction, that will yield an amide and water. On the other hand, if the reaction were going in the reverse direction, we would take an amide plus water in a so-called hydrolysis reaction using water to lyse or break the amide bond to yield an amine and a carboxylic acid. Let's focus on the reaction in the forward direction for this video, going from an amine plus a carboxylic acid reactant to yield an amide and water as the product. I'm going to start by drawing in a generic amine molecule. In my generic amine, I'm going to keep one hydrogen present there, and I'm going to show the other two as R groups. And R here can be either carbon or hydrogen. It could be a carbon chain, a carbon ring, whatever you like. I'm going to react with the carboxylic acid. Remember, carboxylic acid has a COOH group. It can be abbreviated as COH. It can also be shown as a line angle formula here with our carbonyl bonded to OH. I'm going to plug an R group in here, which again, that can be really either a carbon or a hydrogen, as long or as short as you want, a ring, an aromatic ring, whatever, doesn't matter. Biologically, this enzyme would be catalyzed by an enzyme or by the ribosome in the case of looking at protein assembly. In this purpose here, we actually only really need heat in order to drive this reaction, to provide the energy necessary for the reaction to occur. And in fact, oftentimes when you see this reaction written, you won't even see the heat written there. It will be assumed and implied that it is available. Now, what happens to yield the amide product plus water is that the hydroxy group from our carboxylic acid, shown here, and the hydrogen atom, shown here, ultimately become water on the product side of the equation. So I'm going to go ahead and write in my water. And the other product of this reaction corresponds to forming a bond between the nitrogen atom here and the carbonyl group of the carboxylic acid. And in fact, the electron pushing arrow here that I'm showing to illustrate how this is happening is actually how it happens in reality, is that the lone pair of electrons on the nitrogen is used to form a covalent bond of the carbonyl group after the hydroxy group here has left or broken away from the molecule. So what we are essentially doing is replacing the hydroxy group from the carboxylic acid with the nitrogen and whatever two R groups are bonded to it here and here to make that amide product. So let's go ahead and draw out our amide product. We had our carbonyl directly bonded to the R group. I'm going to highlight that here in green in our starting structure and green in our product. So what I've highlighted in green is what's derived from the carboxylic acid. Now the carboxylic acid carbonyl is bonded now with a red bond to our nitrogen atom. I put that bond in red here because it matches the color of the electron pushing arrow that we used to give us a brief illustration of what's happening in this reaction. Now that nitrogen is still directly connected to two R groups being carbons or hydrogens, here and here, because nothing has happened to break the bond between the carbons and the nitrogen. That's a relatively stable bond. And so in drawing this out, we'll go ahead and leave the R group here and the R group here that was bonded to our nitrogen atom. And the nitrogen will end up ultimately with a lone pair of electrons on it, because when the hydrogen atom breaks away from here, that leaves a pair of electrons there with no home. Those poor homeless electrons go onto the nitrogen, and that gives us the lone pair that we see on the product there. So our nitrogen on the two R groups that were yellow on the reactant side are yellow on the product side as well. And now you will see that we have formed this amide group here with this bond that links the carbonyl to our nitrogen, being referred to as our amide bond or our amide linkage. Now let's take a look at a couple of example problems to apply this knowledge that we have just learned. I highly recommend you hit the pause button, try these problems on your own, and then hit play to see if you got the answer correctly. Let's start with the top. Butane-1-amine, I'm going to go ahead and draw out as a four-carbon chain with a nitrogen atom at carbon number one of that four-carbon chain. Now that nitrogen, to fill its complete octet, since we don't have any alkyl groups listed here as N-alkyl groups, we'll have to have NH2 in order to have its complete octet there. Then we react with pentanoic acid, so I'm going to put it in as my COOH group there, with a 5-carbon chain including the carbonyl carbon. So now we have our 5-carbon chain, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Reacting those two groups, what will happen in the course of this reaction is that we will take one of the two hydrogen atoms from the nitrogen. To illustrate that, I'm actually going to draw this out not as just NH2, but I'm actually going to explicitly show both of the hydrogen atoms so that we can track the destination of each of those. Now, what happens in this reaction is that the OH from our carboxylic acid and one of the two H's from our amine are going to link together to form water as one of the two products of that reaction. I'll put that in red, and I'll actually highlight it in red as well to match the color coding that we used over on the reactant side of the equation. And then the nitrogen atom and the hydrogen that it's carrying along are going to form a covalent bond over to the carbonyl group that I've highlighted in yellow here, and then I'll highlight the rest of this chain as well. So we're going to link the nitrogen atom to our carbonyl group there. So let's go ahead and do that. Drawing out our nitrogen atom, our nitrogen was directly bonded to two hydrogens. Now it's bonded to just one hydrogen because the other hydrogen became one of the two hydrogens of H2O. Draw out our four carbon chain there in total. I'm going to highlight all of that in green to match the color that it was to start with. That is going to form a bond, which I will show in red to match the electron pushing arrow that I illustrated here, over to the carbonyl of our, what once was our carboxylic acid. And that has a total of 5 carbons in the chain since it was pentanoic acid. I will highlight all of that in yellow to match the color that we were using on the reactant left side of the equation. So our final product here will correspond to this, where we've linked, in essence, the carbonyl group of the carboxylic acid with the nitrogen of the amine and whatever carbon chain it's bonded to and one of those two hydrogens. And then H2O is formed by taking one of the hydrogens from the amine and the hydroxy group from the carboxylic acid. We can also do this type of reaction in reverse. In the top here, we saw our equilibrium that yielded water and an amide. If we start with water and an amide, our products here will be an amine plus a carboxylic acid always. So I'm just going to sketch in amine plus CA to remind myself of what's happening here. Since this is the reverse reaction, rather than this bond in red being formed, that is the bond between the carbonyl and the nitrogen, instead, that bond between carbonyl and nitrogen is going to be broken. So let me highlight that bond here, the bond between the carbonyl and the nitrogen in our reactant here. That's the bond that will be broken. So I'm going to even label that. This is the bond to break. And what happens when that bond breaks is that as that bond breaks, using water as the reactant to break that, the OH group of water comes in and forms the OH group of the carboxylic acid product. The other hydrogen that's left over from that comes in here to allow us to have NH2. And therefore, our product of this reaction would be a methyl group, CH3, directly bonded to nitrogen. Now, nitrogen, rather than just being NH, will pick up one extra hydrogen from H2O. So it's going to, rather than being NH, it's going to be NH2. And then the carboxylic acid product will correspond to what we have over here. So we had a 3-carbon chain with a carbonyl on it. so three carbon chain including the carbonyl, and then that will be bonded to an OH group donated from water. So highlighting to match the groups and their locations to track them, H2O is going to become the OH group, and it's going to become one of the two hydrogen atoms on that amine. Let me show that explicitly here by going ahead and getting rid of that NH2 and spelling that out a little more fully here. So I will go ahead and do that. NH2 can be written like so. And one of those two H's originated from H2O's water. So I'm going to go ahead and highlight that. So the water that was in pink on the left, now that that water has been used to lyse or break the amide bond, the OH group from water goes here onto the carboxylic acid. The other leftover hydrogen from water goes onto the amine. And then our amine functional group, which is NHCH3, derived from NHCH3 over here in green. Now in yellow, I will show the carbonyl group and the three carbon chain is the carbonyl group and the three carbon chain over here. Now that we have broken that amide bond, yield always a carboxylic acid and an amine. And as we continue onward into the upcoming chapter on proteins and also a chapter on enzymes, we'll be applying this information because as proteins are constructed from amino acids, we will see that the reaction on top is taking place where we are forming amide bonds out of amino acids to make protein chains. On the other hand, when proteins are catabolized and broken down into their individual amino acids, this reaction on bottom where water is used as a reactant to lyse or break the amide bond and release amines and carboxylic acids is the reaction that goes on there when proteins are being degraded.